Hello everyone, welcome to today's session. I'm very happy to see all of you. Today we are going to do something cool. I will show you how a proper lead cycle looks like, and I will also show you how it's being done. So let's start. So we're starting from, you know, a website, and we're going to the contact us, and I will fill the information. Let's have here some information. This is Bob Rim, and this is his email. Please send me more info about your services, and we'll send it. So behind the scenes, if I will go to Zoho, which is my favorite CRM, if I'm going to the web forms, you can see that I created a web form with all those details, which those are the details necessary for my specific business. Whenever the lead is being filled, the lead will start with the contact us page, which this is the page. And once I'm submitting the form, it will go to the thank you page. And that was the page that I just landed on. Now, a few things will happen once it's being done. The lead owner, which is me, I will receive an email that tells me that I just got a new lead because I need to get this notification. And from the other side, my client will get, or my lead will get, an email that telling him that I just got his details and he needs to be prepared for my response. Now, I also installed on his computer a special cookie that will verify whenever he is back on my website, because I like to know if I got this specific lead. I like to know if he is returning to my website, right? It will be a positive feedback for me that everything is working fine. Let's go to my email and see what's going on. So in my email, you can see that I just got a notification that's saying that I just got a new lead. Now, this is a small tip for you. When you're getting a new lead, don't include the lead details. The reason is that most of us are very lazy. And instead of going to the CRM and call the person while you're in front of the computer, you will just do it from your cell phone on the road, right? And the chance of conversion will go down dramatically. So you're better off just know that you got a new lead, and then you will go to your CRM and then you will check it out. Okay, so let's go to the CRM. Okay, so Bob Rim, I just got it as a new lead, right? So I can click on Bob Rim and then I can start the conversation with him. Okay, now from the other side, I'm also a client. So if I'm checking here, I just got a new email that's telling me thank you for your inquiry and someone is going to contact you in the next 10 minutes. Okay, so that's the beginning of the process. Now, in addition, I did one more thing. If I'm going to the automation section, I created a short workflow that basically says, whenever a lead is being created, do this rule, apply this rule on all the leads, and 15 minutes after the lead was created, send an email with a questionnaire. So that's an email that I created in advance. Okay, the lead will be, the email will look like that. Hello, Bob, my name is Lior, because it's pulling the account manager from the CRM, and there will be a link to a form. Now, the reason I'm sending the form after 15 minutes and not immediately, it's because if the client will get an email immediately, he will know that this is an autoresponder and he will not treat it as a serious email. If I'm waiting 15 minutes, it will look like a human being got the email, crafted an email, and sent it back to the client. So I got better conversions using this technique. So I'm waiting 15 minutes and then I'm shooting the email. Try it out. It's actually great feedback. Now, let's go back to my mailbox. Next, I'm supposed to get to my mailbox an email with the link to the form, and that will be probably in the next 15 minutes. So whenever I'm getting it, I will initiate the session again. Until then, you're on pause. I will see you soon. Okay, 15 minutes are over, and now I just got this email. Hello, Bob, my name is Lior, and I have a link to the questionnaire. Now, the questionnaire is integrated with the CRM, which means whatever details that are already existing in the CRM, those details will be pulled into the questionnaire. Whatever details that I will input into the form will get pushed into the CRM. So it's two-way sync between the CRM and Zoho survey. That's the beauty about Zoho. Everything is just connected, right? So let's enter the details. Okay, I'm just writing some details here. Next, what kind of services are you interested in? And those will be those services, and submit. Now, whenever I'm submitting the form, two things will happen. One, in my Zoho CRM, if I will go to my lead, you can see that I got the bell, and the bell is notifying me that my lead just responded to the questionnaire. And from the other side, you can also see that I got the questionnaire and I can view the responses. So everything is being done, as I told you, automatically. I don't need to do anything except just watching the information. Okay, I got here all the details, which is perfect. Whenever the lead completes the questionnaire, I will get an email that's telling me that the lead just completed the survey, and I will go back to my CRM and I can review the details. So everything actually is in one place, which is pretty nice. Behind the scene, if I'm going to my survey, you can see that page number one is everything we just added here and the services. Now, in order to edit the survey, it's just a click. You can click on the plus and you can add more fields. You can drag and drop more questions. Yes, no. And eventually it's just a drop down. You can do everything that you want. Now, in order to create the trigger that will send me an email, I just created this kind of small integration that's saying whenever the questionnaire is submitted, send an email to me with all the responses. Okay, it's a very basic integration that allows me to view my lead responses. That's it, really. That was a very simple integration between Zoho Survey and Zoho CRM. The website, by the way, was created by Zoho Sites. It took me probably 2 minutes to create this website with all the integrations. It's very, very easy. The website design is very basic, nothing special about it, but it's very quick and inexpensive because it's just part of the $30 a month that I'm paying to Zoho. I can have a website, Zoho surveys, Zoho leads, whatever. Everything is in one place. Thank you very much for watching. If you liked the video, give me thumbs up. If you didn't like it, send me a comment. I like to review it so I can create better videos for you. Thank you very much. See you soon.